أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم In the name of Allah who is the most merciful and beneficent So we are going to start our lecture with the moral lesson The dunya world is not the resting place It is the testing place So don't consider that you will be staying for here forever All of us has to leave this place one day And so for this keep doing good deeds and respect your elders etc and please your god now the next thing today we are going to study chapter number 5 water processing from page number 62 till page number 65 and I am your teacher Aisha Ashraf yes students now the topic which we are going to study today is basically water treatment These are all the steps of water treatment as we people know that in the whole world we have studied that round about 71% water is present and that is not drinkable that is not in use because it's saltish etc. So with the help of this water treatment we make water drinkable we recycle that dirty water which contains harmful impurities inside it. So these following are all the steps of the water treatment basically the number one screening aeration and pre-chlorination coagulation and flocculation sedimentation filtration chlorination and supplementary treatment yes now water processing clean water is one of the basic condition to sustain of life and the dirty water contains impurities inside it and due to that many kind of stomach disorders can occur for example diarrhea typhoid cholera and due to that reason water becomes contaminated so it should be recycled before you it should be processed and all the harmful microorganism impurities should be removed from it yes when we are going to start the treatment of water The number one treatment, the number one stage is pre-treatment. Now in this stage, what happens that the water is being prepared for this processing, all the micro impurities are being removed. And these all stages of water treatment are six in number, which are given below. Number one, screening. Now basically what happens in screening large floating debris the solid particles which are macromolecule which are larger in amount they are being removed from the water by passing through the large screens and these screens act as stainer they collect that solid particles these solid particles are attached to the stainer and the water is being passed so in this way water is being removed all the unwanted solid waste is being removed from the water just look at this from these sheets from these screens the water is being passed and the all the solid waste material is being collected in this way yes the b step number 2 is aeration what is aeration it is a second step after screening what happened the fresh air is introduced into that screen water due to that fresh air if unwanted gases are present pollutants just like carbon dioxide gas and if their microorganisms are present these are being removed easily and the most important thing that the color odor and taste of the water is being improved and this condition this process is called aeration in this process ozone gas is also involved that is also put inside that water and disease causing microorganisms which harms the body of the human being or other animals that are also being killed in the process of aeration yes you can look over here that the air is being introduced into the water which perform its following function now the next is coagulation and flocculation the third step after the water is aerated it is pumped into the coagulation tank the water is being collected in this tank now in this tank what happened the small tiny dirt particles are present small impurities are present and these are being floating inside that tank Now, these small impurities are being converted into the larger particles. How? It is done by the help of alum, aluminium sulfate. The formula is Al2SO4 whole thrice and 18 molecules of water. Then, and after adding this, the constant stirring is done. So what happened that when these particles are added with the impurities, they stick together, the impurities started collecting, they adhere together, they come at one surface and they are converted into large size and they suspend in the water. When they are starting suspending in the water and converted into larger particles, so these are named as flocs. This process is called coagulation and flocculation. Now they are saying that these micro impurities are removed from preheated water. Okay. Yes, you can see the picture over here that these are the impurities which are spread throughout the water. The alum is being added. And afterwards, what happened that the coagulating forms the for example that aluminium sulfate is being added, it makes flocs like this. These flocs settle down at the bottom of the coagulation tank. Yes, the next step is basically sedimentation. What happens in the process of sedimentation that the flocs continue growing size, and when they approaches, they become heavier. Then the water molecules, they settle at the bottom of the tank, as I have told you before in the previous slide. And at this stage, when that flocs are being at, present at the bottom of the tank, the process of stirring is being stopped. The flocs are settled down, and that settling is completed. Water become less turbid, means it becomes opaque. All the impurities are being removed, they are drying. And in this way, what happened, those subtle flocs are called sludge. What is basically sludge? Sludge is the thick viscous liquid which is present, the thick material. And this whole process of collecting and converting the impurities into sludge is called sedimentation. Yes, you can see over here that the suspended particles are present. They are collected at the bottom and then it is pumped out from that water tank to make the water clean. The third stage is basically filtration, that what flocculated water particles which consist of so many flocs, which consist of sludge, it is sent into the filtration tank. And layers of coal and sand and gravels filter that water. The sludge is being collected over there. The clean water is being passed from these layers and it comes out, and all in this way the process of filtration is being proceed. And now over here the water is almost clean, but it is not ready to use. There are further steps which are coming. So just have a look of this picture which is being given in front of you. This is the filtration process in water treatment. Yes, the next step is step 4 is chlorination. Chlorine is a non-metal, it is an element, it is antiseptic and disinfectant also. It helps to kill the germs. Now that filter water still have germs inside it which can harm the people. Now chlorine is added inside it to sterilize it, to make it pure from the impurities, to kill the germs so that no bacteria should be there, and it is very effective disinfectant. Now after the process of chlorination, what happened, neutralization process occurs. Okay, what happens in basically neutralization, that alkalis and acids combine together to form salts and water. That water which is obtained after chlorination consists of some chemicals inside it, for example alum and chlorine. And they can harm the water, the people also when they drink. It can make the water acidic, it can make the water basic. So in the last stage of the water treatment, lime is added. Lime, calcium oxide, what happens, it neutralizes the effect all these chemicals. The water is neither acidic, neither it is basic or alkaline. It becomes neutral. The pH value of water is 7 and it is ready to be used to drink. Just see the picture over here. They are telling you about chlorination, that chlorine gas is being added to the water to disinfect that. The last stage, the stage number 6, is storage and supply. Water is clean and ready to use, and it is being stored in the tank, and then they are transferred, they are being pumped toward the houses. And one thing important, that this water treatment, this water processing is done on a large scale to provide water to the houses. Treatment of water to make it mineral free. It is another matter to clean the water. What happens, that the water consists of salt or minerals inside it. What we do, basically we remove that soluble salt and minerals from that solution, from that water basically. So how we do it, we take a thermometer, we are having a flask and a condenser. What happens, water is boiled. When the water starts boiling, what happens, the water evaporates into the in the form of water vapors, in the gaseous form. Then it is collected, it is passed through a condenser. When it is passed to a condenser, those water vapors convert back into the liquid again. That liquid is supplied by cold water, which consists of vapors, and condenses into the liquid again, and then it is collected into a container. And as a result, the salts and other impurities remain in the flask. Just look at this. What happened, that over here the process of boiling starts. The water vapors, the water is being converted into vapors, then it is being transmitted, it is moved towards this condenser here. Due to help of cooling effect, it is converted back into the liquid. Now over here, when all the water was being converted into vapors, the salt and minerals remain over here, and in this way water is being separated out from all those minerals and salt. The water obtained is absolutely pure. It is called distilled water. It is mineral free and it consists of essential salts inside it, and it is now drinkable. This is also the picture of process of distillation. Yes, do you know, at page number 64, the process practice at industrial level, and it is also termed as desalination. Why it is called desalination? Because in this process we basically remove the salts from the water, we desalinate the water. Distillation is used in countries where there are big oceans present, because the ocean water is basically salted, it is not drinkable. So people use the process of distillation to desalinate and make it drinkable for use. The next is purified water and distilled water. Purified water, it is treated water, it is free from harmful substances, contaminants. It contains minerals required for health, essential minerals are present, and it is purified water. But in case of distilled water, it is also the treated water. It free from contaminants and as well as from minerals also. It is present in its purest form. It contains hydrogen and oxygen, and it is also recommended for drinking. I hope that grade 7 you have understood the lecture. And if there is any problem, you can ask your teacher in the live session. So, Allah Hafiz, stay blessed.